We thank you this hour, God, for this divine opportunity which thou hast given again for us to gather. Many slept last night the way we do. They could not wake up this morning, but your mercy have done this. Have woken us up this morning. It's not that we are better or righteous, holier than those that are gone, but for a purpose you kept us. And I pray that purpose, oh God, will be taken care of properly by us in your mercy, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Father, we are here to hear from you and not from us. As you know, the mercy that is coming forth is talking to me. Lord, I pray you will open our hearts to your word in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord Jesus, Amen. I ask for forgiveness of every error in my life. Every sin in my life, please forgive me and purge me of it. Let me not stand here speaking your word in sin. Please dip me in your blood and make me whole. Oh God, likewise, everyone sitting around you, around your table to eat from you right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, amen. I decree that you increase. I step out and you step in. I step down and you step up and take over the pulpit. To talk to us in the language that we understand. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. Second Corinthians, chapter 7, verse 1. Second Corinthians 7, I read verse 1. Having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all fittingness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. Amen. By the special grace of God, the message we are about to hear, it's not a message that we don't know about, but I believe the Lord knows why he wants us again to hear the word. Like what we read right now said, because of the promises that we have, what are the promises? If you go to the book of John chapter 14, verse 1 to 3, it told us that as I you believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. I am going to prepare for you a place after which I have finished. We'll come again to take you that where I am, there you will be also. Those in hell right now are not in where Christ is also. This is the promises that is telling us, since we have these promises, my children, this you must do. Because although I promise you, telling you that yes, I go to prepare a place for you, after which I have done, I will come to take you. And where I am, there you will be also. For you to be able to be qualified, or for you to be qualified to be among the number, is telling us now to cleanse ourselves from every fitness of this flesh and spirit. That is why the topic before me and you says, not only your outward, but also your inward man demanded. Not only your outward, but also your inward man is what is demanded. Your inward man demanded. I once remember I talked to a pastor by the grace of God about the church, a pastor. I said, pastor, why are your congregation, why are they dressing this way? He told me It doesn't matter. That God, in what he's trying to let me know, that God does not look at the outward man, but the inward man. But one thing he forgot, is that it is the spirit that controls the flesh. Meaning, whatever you do physically, it must be done spiritually. And the Lord is telling us, my sons and daughter, because of the high time we are now, I want to advise you on what must qualify you to come to me. Having therefore this promise, I have promised that I am going to prepare a place for you, that in my Father's house is full of many mansions, and for you to be among the ones that shall definitely enter into that place. If you see where we just read that book of 2 Corinthians 7 verse 1, it do not refer to one part, it refers to the both sides. Flesh is the one you can see. And it talks of the spirit, the inner man. Perfecting holiness in the fear of God. Today is actually by the special grace of God. You can see the first part of the topic. It talks about the outward. Before it go to the aspect of the inward man. Do you know why? Because many of us, let me refer it to the female. Many of us actually are wearing gown up to the extent your leg cannot be seen anymore, your foot cannot be seen anymore. But your inward man is wearing mini skirt. Praise the Lord. Many believers that you see, there is no earrings. Many believers that you see that they are no more putting on trousers, which refer to both man and woman. Many you see that they don't make up physically. Many that you see, they are holding Bible physically. They don't have Bible spiritually. Many that you see, their list is very natural, but in their inner man, the Lord is saying, your mouth is painted. Many of us that don't put on trouser, the Lord is saying, I can see you putting on trouser inside of you. We may say, what is the trouser? What are we talking about? Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. For you to know what the Lord is saying, in the book of Matthew 23, let's see what the Lord is telling. What is referring to? That thing that refers to earrings in your inner man. That thing that refers to your trouser in your inner man. That thing that reflect that is representing your listings in inwardly. Let's see how where it is, what the Lord is saying. In the book of Matthew 23, I want us to quickly read verse 25 to 27, 28. He said, woe unto you, I will start from verse 24 to 28. Ye blind guys, we stream at a gun, and swallow a camel. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye make clean the outside of the cup and of the platter, But with thee, they are full of extortion and access. 26, thou blind Pharisees, cleanse first that which is within, the cup and platter, that the outward of them may be clean also. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye are like unto winter sepulchres, which indeed appear beautiful with your skirt and whatever you think of it outward, but are within full of dead men bones and all uncleanness. Even so ye also outwardly appear righteous unto men, but within ye are full of hypocrisy and iniquity. Do we see the trust that the Lord is talking about? That many believers. That is why I don't know if I will say, you that is saying, I am a holiness setup. This is holiness setup. Are you sure? I want to ask myself and you this question. If you have a Hummer Jeep, Hummer car, and I have Mercedes, will you tell me because the Hummer Jeep, for example, is more costly than the Mercedes, and because of that, you will not tell me that the car, the Mercedes, is no longer cocker. They only have great, but all is car. All can drive one person, one man to the other. What do I mean? You that have all magic, and you that have Mercedes, car is car. And both of them can be drive. Both of them can take you to where you want to take you to. Meaning, if you are outwardly okay, and I am inwardly okay, I explain again. If I am outwardly okay, and you are inwardly okay, and your outward man is not okay, and my inward man is not okay, are they not the same? They are the same. They say we end up in the same place. There is no difference between those that are inwardly okay and outwardly okay. If you see where we read at first, and you even see where we read now, you say you are full of dead men, but you are pure, holy, righteous before man. But instead of you are full of dead men, but are like a grave that is very beautiful as outward. But inside is full of dead men bones. He told us in where we read at first, dearly beloved, cleanse your flesh and spirit. He didn't say only flesh. He didn't say only spirit. Meaning, both of them are important before God. If it's not important, he wouldn't refer us to both. He would refer us to the one he knows is important. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Brethren, not only your outward man Christ is talking about, he also need your inward man. In another case, God do not need your inward man alone. He also need your outward man. Both of them must be equal. Both of them must be equal. The Bible told me and you, in the same book of Matthew chapter 5, verse 20. It said, in Matthew 5:20, look at what it said. This place we are about to read. It's a thing that will make me and you to strive very well. If you understand this place, sister, brother, you and I need to pull. We need to strive. We need to go to extra mind. He said, for I say unto you that except your righteousness shall exceed the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees, ye shall in no case enter into the kingdom of heaven. Sister, are you sure your righteousness have exceeded that of the Pharisees? If not, do something. Brother, are you sure that your righteousness have exceeded that of the Pharisees? Because the Lord, his word, as we know, he honor it more than what his name. And the devil, listen to me, that Bible you hold, that you and I have in our head, the devil also have his own. The devil is also having his own. As you are doing, as you are speaking, he will be opening it. You know, we have in everything. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And the Bible tells me, are you? In the book of 1 John. 1 John chapter 3. I read verse 7. 1 John 3 verse 7. And the Lord told me, are you? He said, little children, let no man deceive you. He that doeth righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. He that doeth, let no man deceive you. If you are saying yes, because you don't wear trouser anymore, you don't know ear in your ear, that is what will usher you to the kingdom of God. And meanwhile, your inner man is full of dead man bones. We know what we are talking about when we talk about dead man bones. Dead man bones refer to jealousy, hatred, anger, bitterness, pride, loss. All these are the dead man bones. Are we sure we are all free from these things? If not, there is a problem. The dead man bones are those sin, iniquity. Are we free that is talking? Am I sure I am free from it? If not, I better do something. Not now that the time is running faster than ever before. That is why the time we are is a time of sober reflection. That is why the time we are is a time of what? Self-examination. Daily self-examination, not weekly self-examination. Daily. Impossible, brother. Every hour we all need to examine ourselves. After you go ahead and discuss with that person, go and examine all that you discuss with her or him to see if you have wronged God. That is the time we are now. For he that is righteous. Let us not deceive ourselves. It didn't say let no man deceive you. It said do what? Let no man deceive you. He says so. And he said, don't be deceived also in his word. Don't let your inner man. And sister, how will you put on attachment now? It doesn't matter. My inner one is okay. So you mean because of you now, God will not lower his word. No, I don't. Can't you see there's no more anger in me? But trouser that you are wearing, you go, no, it doesn't matter. My inner man is okay. Sister, that anger in you, that pride, that love, that jealousy. No, sister, can't you see I don't wear trouser anymore? I am not, can't you see I am so plain? You are deceiving yourself. The other time we talk about walk in your privacy. This is the time. Listen to me. Listen to me. Let me listen to myself. Either is now or what or never. It's now for me and you to work on our privacy or never. If it's not now, meaning you can never anymore. Do you know why? You can see the whole things, where things are going on. And the Bible told us in that same First John 3, I read verse 3. It says, and every man that had this hope in him purifies yet himself, even as he is pure. Everyone that Christ had told, I am going to prepare a place for you. All he need to do, because the master is coming on the day we did not know. Because you and I, listen to me, many that slept last night, I tell you, they say, many told their parents, their children, and say, good night, we see tomorrow. The tomorrow, they never see it. All. Many just slept last night. There was no single sickness in them. Mama woke up, are you not going to work today? Mama, it's time for me to go to school. Come and get me ready. They never woke up. Do you think you are different from them? Or am I thinking I'm different from them? Brother, the Lord is saying, I don't need one part of you to be holy. I need your both sides to be holy. That is why he said to me, are you? In the book of Philippians chapter 2, verse 12, he said to me, are you, in verse 12 of Philippians chapter 2, wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation, sister, brother, with fear and trembling. This is not time to look at somebody. This is not time to imitate anybody. This is not time to say, that one is not doing it, I will not do it. Face your own. Even your mother will stand. You see the children around you. They will stand on their own. You cannot say, no, my God, it's my son. Let me speak for her. Let me speak for him. No. Everybody is on her own. Therefore, the Lord is saying, work out your salvation. Work your salvation out with fear and trembling. Oh, I don't want the master to meet me unprepared. That is the fear. Oh, God, this anger must go. This pride must go. Father, no. If I don't know where you are coming, take away this thing from me. You have your, if you are not serving God in fear, you will not be afraid of that sin. Because any sin you are afraid of, you will take it to God in prayer. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We don't have much time. The Bible told me, are you, in the book of First Thessalonians chapter 5, I read 22-23. And the Bible told me, are you, abstain from all appearance of evil. First Thessalonians chapter 5, 22-23. Abstain from all appearance of evil. Those of us that want to go to heaven, let's look at verse 23 very well, so that we will stop referring ourselves or focusing on one side. I pity those that said attachment, whatever, makeup, all those things are not matter. They should see what the Lord is saying right now. He said, and the very God of peace sanctify you wholly. And I pray, God, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. We see, God do not stop in one. In all of them, he make us understand that your body is very important to him. Your body, if it's not holy and your inner man is holy, you are on your own. If not, he would have just said, the very God cleanse your spirit and leave it there. We are just saying your very soul and your very body or your spirit is okay, and leave the other one. But he make sure all of them now, so that you will know, I will know, all of them is important. That is why he said to me, are you, not only your outward man, sister, not only your outward man, brother, also your inward man is demanded to be what? To be holy. And the Lord will help us all in the name of Jesus Christ. Lastly, because of time, the Bible told us in the book of Romans chapter 12 that we know very well. Romans 12, I read 1-2. Praise the Lord. Romans chapter 12, verse 1 and 2.
He said, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your body a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, and that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye and I, every one of us, should present our body a living sacrifice. Meaning, present your body holy, present your inner man holy. The tool is demanded, is required for heaven. Those of us that went to school, whether primary school or nursery school, especially from primary school or to, from secondary school, we see there are some subjects that have practical and theory. If you pass most of the subject in your theory and the practical does not go, just for example right now, like the country I was before, if you go to do exam, driving school, if you pass the theory, if you do not pass the practical, they will not give you your license. You are failed. That is exactly what God is saying now. If you go to the exam hall, you pass the theory, and you come to the test, you want to drive the car, which is the practical, and you fail, you have to start again. That is exactly what God is saying. Both practical and theory is demanded. The outward man should be the practical. Why the theory that man see not should be the inner man. And both of them need to be worked on and make sure it's perfect so that heaven will be sure for you and me. The Lord only come to talk to me. I believe also you. And the Lord will help me, will help you in Jesus' name. If you have heard the word, I want you to talk to God. I say, Father, actually, I want to do this that you have asked me to do now. I am ready for it, but I have no power of my own. I need help. I need help to be delivered from all the dead man bones that is living in me. All the dead members, that thing I want to remove it, but I have no power to remove it, physically or spiritually. Tell God now. Remind him of his word that said, by strength shall no man prevail. Tell God, Father, I want to be holy. Lord, I need help. You said you need both now. Lord, I want to be holy. I want to come to your kingdom, not the kingdom of the devil. So help me, God. Open your mouth and talk to God if you understand. In the name of Jesus Christ. I want to be there, Father. Have mercy and help me. You know me more than I do. I want to be really holy as you commanded. I want my inner and outward man to be pure and holy without any excuse to pain. But I have no power to do it. I have no power to do it. Father, have mercy and help me. It's a serious matter, Lord. But I don't want to deceive myself. My righteousness has not exceeded that of the Pharisees. Papa, help me. Jesus Christ, mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
The Lord have heard us, but I want you to, we see yesterday in the Bible study, the first reading, Luke 18. The Bible said the woman was going to and fro until that she needed was granted to her. She never relents. That is why the topic said strive yesterday. Strive to the end. Try. Do your best. So therefore, what am I trying to say? Sister, let us go. Brother, let us go and trouble heaven. Because sugar that is being placed in our mouth, nobody they place sugar in this for our mouth that will vomit out. Heaven is a sugar that must not be vomit out of our mouth. And sin is what is, he want to do it. So don't allow him. And that will be done only if you tell God, if you trouble heaven. Are you out there, you are not born again? Or you have not given your life to Christ? Maybe you are a Christian, you are saying, and the outward man does not matter. You are here now, we read it together in the Bible. Or you have not given yourself, your life to Christ at all. Sister, brother, tomorrow may be too late. Why not do it now? I beg of you to confess Jesus Christ now as your Lord and personal Savior so that you not eternally regret. And invite Christ. And after you have done that, I want you to go further for baptism. And if you want the men of God on this mountain to assist you in the area of baptism, or you need counsel, please, you can kindly call on the men of God. The Lord will make them available and give them the grace to assist you. And at the end, your life will not be the same again. What about many of us here also that have went back? It is time now. The remaining second that is remaining for us to depart from this world, let us use it to go back to God. And at the end, our life will not remain the same. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. Thank you for your word that have come to me and your children. Father, as we are praying, we have no strength of our own. Actually, I can't see that there's anyone here that don't want to come to that your kingdom. Father, I gather everyone from myself. We all run into your mercy seat this hour. We all come, oh God, into your intensive clinic. That is Jesus Christ, your mercy. Work on us until we are perfect and fit for your kingdom. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. May this one not stand against me or against your children at the last day. Because we can't bear it long. Have mercy and help us. We need help, for by strength shall no man prevail. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, have I added to your word? All subtracted from it. I am sorry, Lord. Please forgive me. Anyway, I have spoken against you, have mercy on me. Anyone that was angry, forgive them, for we all know not what we are doing. Wash us all with your precious blood. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we are praying with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Bless you, sir.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God bless you, beloved Almighty God. God Almighty, continue to strengthen you, empower you. And on the last day, your labor for the work will not be in vain. This world will not be against you, will not be against your force, or rather, it will chastise everyone's force to come at last in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Brethren, the Lord has spoken to you, to me, and to all of us this morning.